Hey there, how y'all doing? This is Weapons Tech Matt coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. And tonight, I'm going to do a little review on a budget Glock clone. And this is the FMK C1 9mm. It's a Gen 2. I'll verify I said everything right on here. FMK 9C1 Gen 2. This is in the sniper gray. And we'll verify she's empty. Nothing there. Nothing in the magazine. So, initial impressions. Well, you'll see my unboxing when I initially got this gun. And it come in a cardboard box with the gun, a magazine, and a QR code scan so you could go download the manual. That's it. A cardboard box. Not a very big one. But the gun itself, that's the main thing. And I'll be taking it to the range in a day or so. So we'll see how this thing performs. It's supposed to be kind of a cheap version of a Glock 19. Well, we'll see about that. But one of the things I am pretty impressed with is the ergonomics. It feels really good in the hand. Matter of fact, a little better than my Glock 19 does. It has kind of a rubber backstrap here. And well, let's just kind of take a look at the gun in awe. It's a American-made gun. It's made in California. Well, I know. I mean, I'd be kind of scared if I was the owner of that company making guns in California. But anyway, I'm glad they're able to make a go of it. And they're very patriotic. Matter of fact, they have some versions of this gun that have the Bill of Rights on it. This one has a little thing on the frame that says, thank you, Armed Forces, and American made. So that's pretty cool. But it is a polymer frame and a steel slide that has some kind of a nitrite coating or whatever. I'll look that up and see exactly what kind of coating that is. It is same kind of a Glock type of tape down, Glock kind of trigger, and the trigger, well, I don't know if it's quite a Glock trigger, but I've seen worse triggers. It's a little bit spongy, and then it hits a wall, goes through, so it's okay. It's not bad. Probably about a 6.5-pound trigger. It has a Glock type sights, and it does have a long ejector over here, so you're gonna have to kind of watch the way you rack it back, I'm thinking. It has the slide release on the left side, the magazine release on the left side. It lets the magazine go quite nicely. I'm not sure what's up with these magazines. I don't know who makes them. It just says FMK on the mag itself. There's a kind of a red yellow follower inside. Apparently in the Gen 1 of these things had a lot of issues. So hopefully they've cleared that up. Some of the reviews I've seen on this. Gen 2 is not too bad. But the way it feels in the hand, it's pretty good. Well, we'll do all of the breakdown and the tabletop top specifics here in a little bit. But it does have rear striations that are, they're okay. I'm thinking if your hands are oily or sweaty, it's going to be a little harder to rack back. It has this rubberized back strap, and I don't know, that the The grip texture is, it's not very aggressive. I mean, you don't feel much of a difference between it and the other parts of the polymer. But with that rubber back strap, you get a pretty good hold to it, but I'm probably gonna put some kind of talon, something right up in here to kind of hold on to. I don't know if my hands get, especially here in Texas, hands get sweaty, get oily, and things tend to slip. So we'll see how that works. Does have a rail here at the front, put your light or your laser or whatever. And let me show you the what kind of sights. And well, that's pretty much running this budget, the rundown on this budget gun. It kind of has a little more interesting slide than the Glock. It's got some concave and contours to it. You know, it's not a bad looking gun. It feels pretty good in the hand. It doesn't feel cheaply made. So we'll give her a run at the range here a couple of days, and I'll do a tabletop breakdown on it, and we'll go to that end. All right, so I'm doing this little open box on this FMK. G9C1 Generation 2 Super Budget kind of Glock clone. This is a box at Cubhead. Like I said, $260. You're not going to get any kind of fancy plastic box, that sort of thing. So it comes in a cardboard box. And let's see, the gun, I got the Sniper Gray, verify that it's empty. It is. This is just a open box thing. I'll show you what comes into this box here. I mean, this is pretty basic stuff. 269 at Palmetto, and if you want to download the instruction manual, you can scan that QR code right there. It comes with a magazine and a gun and a cardboard box and a couple of ads. That's it. I'm gonna go out and run this thing at the range the next day or two, and we'll do a total proper review on this, but I just wanted to show you the very Spartan thin things that this come with. This is what $269 will get you. Hopefully the gun will perform more than what its presentation is. But anyway, that's my initial introduction to the FMK. So, okay, 14 more, here we go. I did it that time. Okay, so we have the FMK cleaned up. We've got some Remington, I think they're 115 grain, brand new box. Let's see what happens. See if it slides home as soon as I put this magazine in. No, it didn't this time. All right, here we go. Didn't kick home. That's good. Let's get back up. No problem. Okay, so I'm going to run the last of this box of 50. Yeah, it's about 12 rounds. So one out of a box of 50. Failure to extract right about round number 38. All right, so we'll see what it looks like. Okay, so 14 more in the FMK. See if it slaps itself home again. Yep, that seems to be a pattern. All right, here we go. More, no hangups. So let's see what it did. Not bad from 10 yards. That's about 55 rounds right there. Began, started a little low, get the sight pitch. Yeah. But flawless today. All right, Victor gonna give the FMK a run, see how it deals here. Seems to be shooting a bit to the left.
Yeah. Got your ears?
Oh. All right, here we got the FMK. Let's see if it can run 15 without messing up. Okay, so I did headshots. Accuracy is not this gun's problem. It just needs to be maintained pretty clean. After about 30, 40 rounds, it's gonna hang up on you. But if you lube it up, clean it up, it's gonna cycle. And I think I'm done wasting ammunition on this gun. I put 350 rounds through it.
Okay, we're gonna break some steel with this FMK, here we go.
All right, so I'm going to try and put a wrap on this review that has taken, oh crap, 5 weeks to put all this stuff together and over 400 rounds of ammunition multiple times to the range. So let's take a closer look at this FMK 9C1 Gen 2 caliber 9mm striker fired polymer frame pistol. It is a single action. We've got a Glock type of trigger. It does not have a magazine disconnect, so you drop the magazine and rack it in, or you got a round in there, it's going to shoot with or without the magazine. The slide is high carbon steel. The barrel is stainless steel. The frame is a polymer. Of course, this is called Sniper Gray. Of course, they have multiple different colors. So you've got pinks and berries and blues and all of that stuff. Of course, I've showed you the sights. Barrel length is 4 inches. Overall length is 6.85 inches. Height is 5.09 inches. Width is a little over an inch. Weight is 23.5 ounces. Of course, that's empty. And that pretty much rolls this thing in there. Now, we've already talked about the grip. I'm just not going to go into a whole lot of detail. And one thing I didn't mention is it does not have a magazine disconnect. Okay. Now I'm going to kind of show you a comparison to the Glock 19. Because that's what it's trying to be here. Here's it's a Glock 32, but same size as a Glock 19. You can see they're similar in size. This one's about an ounce lighter than the Glock. Of course, this is a Gen 3 Glock. But you can see they're similar size. This is supposed to be FMK's competition to a Glock on the cheap. My experience with Glocks, though, whether they're new out of the box, whether you're using crap ammo, whether you're using any kind of ammo, you pull the trigger, they're going to go bang. It is extremely rare, in my experience with Glocks, to have issues like I've had with this FMK. Now, I will say that the last two boxes, 100 rounds, it went through just fine for the most part. Now, I'll kind of break that down a little bit. But anyway, this is a tabletop look at this thing. And I'm going to kind of pull them both down and show you where. This Glock here has had about twice as many rounds through it as the FMK. So the Glock's pushing close to 1,000 rounds, whereas the FMK is right about 450, something like that. I don't exact count. Well, I'll break them down. You'll see, I'll show you the different wear. I didn't oil this thing up right after I cleaned it. That was just last night. So we'll do that. We'll go to that. All right. So we'll break these two down. Of course, this has Glock style takedown. The little tabs are a little more protruding than the Glock tabs. Oh, I've got that loaded up. Nothing in there though, so that's good. So, similar takedown. Of course, this has a polymer guide rod, whereas my Glock has stainless steel. So, let's look at wear. Now remember, I've just cleaned this last night and I didn't oil it up. One of the things I was a little concerned with is if you look right in there, let's see if I can show it very easy. Right up in there, you can see some wear where the barrel is hitting into that. Okay. I figured I'd look at this Glock and see if we've got similar wear or not. I don't know. This is the first time I thought I'd take a look at it. All right, so same spot in the Glock. Well, looky there. No wear. And this has had at least twice as many rounds through it. More powerful round, too. I mean, nothing in the wear department. That speaks volumes. As you look at the milling inside the Glock, I mean, that's very, look at that, just slick, nice. Whereas the milling in this, you can see the, yeah, it's got tool marks. Got quite a bit of wear right down here where the barrel interacts. Okay. Now, one of the things, well, I'll break that down as I take this thing, do the last wrap up on this, but you can see some wear on the barrel. And the Glock's got a little bit of wear on its barrel, but nothing like this. You're getting edges kind of worn down right here, so the quality of the metal is not as good. Of course, this is a $269 gun compared to, oh, it's five and a half, whatever. So you get what you pay for. You can take the Glock to the range a lot, it's going to be there for you. This here, this FMK, this is not a regular take the range shooter, I don't think. It's not going to hold up to a ton of rounds. So anyway, now I thought I'd bring this up a little closer and let you look at the wear right in there. This is the FMK, and my concern of the wear is right up in there. See that? Okay, you got wear with the barrel contacts right up in there. All right, so let's look at the same spot with the Glock. Nothing. And mind you, this Glock's had twice the rounds and more powerful rounds through it. I know, I'm preaching to the choir, Glocks versus FMKs. But... All right, so let's put a wrap on this FMK. Like I said throughout, is it's a gun I really want to like. And then there's some ways I do. It's definitely ergonomic to hold. It has a good hold to it, a good feel to it. The trigger's not bad. This is a very accurate pistol. Accuracy is not its problem. I've said that several times through this thing. It takes down easy. Quality of build might be a little bit suspect. I kind of showed you that, pointed that out to the wear inside. But, you know, you're getting a budget pistol. And so this is not designed to go out there and, you know, knock off 20, 30,000 rounds. But, hey, if you're, you know, an occasional shooter, you need a gun in the garage or in the, you know, a basic home protection, this might be your thing. And for $269, you know, that's speaking a lot right there, I'll tell you. Now, handling-wise, not a problem. Accuracy, spot on, not a problem. Recoil, very manageable. Even this little rubber butt pad here, this little back strap, absorbs what recoil there is. Easy to rack home, easy to take down, easy to drop the magazine out. One note about the magazines, they're going for about $45 in this budget. Like I pointed out, you get one mag, that's it, 14 round mag. And you know, if you want more magazines, it's going to cost you. Let's see what else. I think the main thing I've found out, now this is my old gunner's mate mind coming in, trying to figure out why is it having failure to extract. That seemed to be one of the big problems as it got dirty, I guess. It would have failure to extract. After about 38, 40 rounds, it started having problems. And from what I could tell, as I took it apart, cleaned it up, after about 35 rounds, you start getting carbon buildup behind the extractor. And that might be the reason why. You know, I cleaned that stuff out of there, and it gets pretty packed in there. And so that could be one of the problems. But, you know, after, I guess you could say, it got broke in a little bit, and after about round 300, it would go through a whole box without any problems. But if you want to go more than 50 rounds without cleaning it, you're going to run into some issues. I did this review, particular, I guess you say, friend of mine. He sent me the gun. He's looking at getting involved with this company in one way or another, I'm not sure. And he wanted me to do a little review. I think they're bringing up their game from the earlier models. And this is definitely an accurate pistol, fairly reliable. I would not take it for my EDC, but if this is all I had, sure. And I'll tell you this, I might make some High Point people mad out there. After about, over the break-in period with this thing, after about round 300, because I put 500 rounds through this thing, it was pretty reliable. Okay, maybe 1 in 50 to have issues with. With the two High Points I have, you'd rarely get through a magazine without it having some issue. Okay. Now, granted, maybe I didn't give them the chance I've given this. And I've since sold both the High Points. Who knows? Maybe I'll get the itch again and buy another High Point. Get me a Yeet cannon. I don't know. But this is about $80 more expensive than a High Point. High Points are ugly and heavy. This is not. This is a fairly nice looking gun. I mean, you've looked at it up close and personal throughout this 5-week ordeal of reviewing this gun. And you can tell, I mean, it's been kicked around. It's been all kinds of places over the last 5 weeks. And that slide has held up. That finish has held up pretty good. Now, I'm not saying inside is, it's showing its wear marks inside, but overall, I guess you could say this thing's held up. So what's my final take on the FMK C9 Gen 2 C1, what the hell? Kind of thumbs up. There's some things they need to clean up on this thing. Whether they'd be able to do it with the price point, I'm not sure. But I'd buy this over a High Point. Like I said, the last three boxes of 50 I took through this, it fired through all of them without any hangup. So I guess it's gotten its second wind. Maybe it's broke in, whatever. But I plan on holding on to this gun, at least for a little while. I don't know what I'm going to use it for. It might be a locker or a safe queen. I don't know. Maybe it'd be a garage gun. Who knows? But I give it a semi-thumbs up, kind of. And interesting pistol, though. Damn good shooter. Yeah. All right, so that's a wrap on the old FMK. And this is Weapons Tech Mac coming to you from a windy, blustery, kind of cold Central Texas this February 17th. And as always, God bless Texas. God bless the United States. And long live the Republic.
Wash away my troubles, wash away my pain.